Hi guys, this is Harsh from shoutmeloud.com and today we are going to learn how we can set up WordPress. I just installed WordPress on one of the domain and I'm going to make some changes, some essential settings that everyone should do after installing WordPress. So this is the fresh installation screen of my WordPress. I'll start with the settings panel. I'll go to the general settings. There I can add few details like my domain name, my name of my website. I can add the tagline. I can change my admin email address. This will be used for sending you email notification for any comments, any new blog post. If you are planning to allow guest posting, you can enable the registration or you can disable it. I would highly recommend that you should change your time settings to match your local time so that when you schedule any blog post, it should not be an issue. Let me search for my timings. So I'll go for Kolkata since I'm in India. I'll click on save changes. So this is for the general settings. After that we'll go to writing. Alright, so what I will be doing, I'll be going under categories, creating a new category under my domain name, Net Hunk, and I'll be refreshing the page and I'll be changing my default category to Net Hunk, and also I'll be updating my ping list. You can get the ping list from the description below and I have it saved. You can get it from here on my blog. Click on save changes, and if you want to enable publishing by Windows Live Writer, which I would recommend, you should try Windows Live Writer, it's really good. Enable XML RPC service, click on save changes. I'll again going back to the category and I'll delete uncategorized category. After that I'll be going to reading section where I'll be making some changes. You have option that you can publish full post in your blog, in your feeds. I usually keep it as a partial feed so that people will come to my blog and read the blog post. You can make other changes which is not necessary here. After that we'll be going to discussion. Here we will be making changes for the comments. So I'll keep the first 2-3 option enabled. Threaded comment, yes, I highly recommend you to keep it enabled. Nowadays most of the WordPress themes comes with threaded comment option enabled. So this is going to be really helpful for the user engagement in your comments. I also recommend you to enable an administrator must always approve the comment. This will make sure that you will have full control over what comment is going in on your blog. Now the another option is the avatar, like the you can go to gravatar.com and you can create your own avatar. You can associate an image with your email address. I'll just change it to gravatar logo. You can choose anything. You can also enable the custom gravatar that I'll cover in another tutorial. Next option is going to media. Here I won't be making any changes. Though if you want, like by default what happens when you upload any image, WordPress resize them into 3 different size: thumbnail size, medium size and large size. Usually I don't use medium size, so I'll keep it 00. This will save some space on my site and I won't be creating extra image on my server. I'll click on save changes. Now many people they ignore this privacy feature. Many on many web hosting, when you install WordPress, by default your privacy settings is set as hidden. So but I want my search engine to index my site so that I get traffic from search engine. I'll click on allow search engine to index this site, save changes. Since it's enabled, I'm not going to make any changes. Now permalink, that's one thing which I would highly recommend that you should make change before publishing any new blog post. I prefer keeping a very simple permalink like your domain name.com, your post name. So this is very simple permalink. We'll be talking about more advanced SEO, permalink SEO in another video. Select that and click on save changes. Apart from that, I would suggest go and delete the default blog post, and same you'll do with the pages. And by the end you'll have a blog with no blog post, but yes, now your blog is set up for the first time. Now we'll be going ahead, we'll be installing plugins, we'll be installing themes, we'll be configuring all essential plugins, and we'll cover all this video, all this tutorial in upcoming videos. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you for watching. This is Harsh from shoutmelod.com.